Charlie Brown of Great Falls, Montana, and Victoria Robinson of Salt Lake City, Utah, have both written in asking whether the idea for tie a yellow ribbon around the old oak tree came from a story that appeared in Reader's Digest a little over a year ago. Yes, it did. But that's not where the story originated. I'll have details coming up. American Top 40. Now, let me tell you the story of the story of the song at number one. In their issue of January 72, the Reader's Digest reprinted a story from the New York Post of October 14, 1971. The writer was Pete Hamill, who said he first heard it from a girl who claimed she was there. Now, he's not sure it really happened, but he likes to think it did. On a New York to Florida bus, there's a convict on his way home after 4 years in a New York prison. And he tells his story to a fellow passenger, who later tells the others. When the convict started serving his time, he had written his wife that if she couldn't take the long separation, to forget about him and find herself a new man. And they hadn't been in touch since. Then a week before he knew he was getting out, he sent her a letter saying he was on his way home, that he'd be on a bus that would pass through the little town of Brunswick, Florida, where they lived, and that if she wanted him back, she should put a yellow handkerchief on the big oak tree on the main highway. And if he didn't see a yellow handkerchief, he'd just keep on riding through, and she wouldn't hear from him again. And you know the rest. When that oak tree came into sight, it was covered with dozens, maybe hundreds of pieces of yellow fabric blowing in the wind. Second week at number one, that's Dawn, and Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree. This is Casey Kasem in American Top 40. Well, we predicted that would be number one, and we were right. AC's Coast
to Coast. Coming up on American Top 40, I have the current hit by the vocal trio who stood on stage and cried when a member of their concert audience, a former POW, got up and told how his homecoming, after 3 years in a North Vietnamese prison camp, brought to life the group's hit song about a yellow ribbon around an oak tree. This is Casey Kasem with American Top 40, and it's time now for the current hit by the vocal group that stood on stage and cried when a member of their concert audience, a former POW, got up and told how his homecoming after 3 years in a North Vietnamese prison camp recreated the story in Dawn's hit from earlier this year. Remember how in Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree, a newly released convict was coming home on a bus looking for his wife's signal that he was still welcome home? Well, the POW at Dawn's concert brought tears to the eyes of the singing group and their audience when he told his story about returning from Vietnam and being picked up at the airport by his family. As they were driving home and got within a mile of their house, the rest of the way, every tree that lined the road was covered with yellow ribbons. And if that doesn't hit you right where you choke up, I don't know what does.
From coast to coast.
Well, are you ready for the tune that ranks number one for 1973? There's a story that's been going around the country for some years. Occasionally, it would appear in print, and last year, Reader's Digest picked it up. Most of the people I know choked up when they read it for the first time. I know I did. It was just one of those stories with a surprise ending that gives you a kick right in the emotions. Tony Orlando and Dawn took that story and made it the biggest hit of 1973. I'm sure you remember Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree. Well, there it is, Tony Orlando and Dawn, and the number one most popular song of 1973, Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree. That's our official wrap-up for 1973. A countdown of the 40 top hits of the past 12 months. The rankings based on Billboard's weekly charts were calculated by the AT40 staff for the one-year period ending with the chart of December 8, 1973. Chief statistician is Ben Marischal. Production supervisor, Lee Hansen. Director, Chuck Olson. Next week, we'll pick up our regular weekly survey once again.
American Top 40 is produced and distributed by Watermark Incorporated, and we tape it here in Hollywood. Producer is Don Bastani. This is Casey Kasem, wishing you all the happiest of New Year's. See you next week. Till then, keep your feet in the ground and keep reaching for the stars.